Hello, good morning, children. Welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. Children, we are about to start our chapter today. Chapter 1, that is Introduction to Accounting. Through this chapter, we will know more about the subject accountancy. So, let us move to the class and hear the lecture video. Children, here is our first chapter, that is Introduction to Accounting. So before we go into this chapter, let us see the content of the chapter. In this chapter, we will have to study the meaning and definition of accounting, attributes, which is also known as the characteristics of accounting, objectives of accounting, functions of accounting, advantages, limitations of accounting, role of accounting in business, accounting process, branches of accounting, bookkeeping, accounting and accountancy, accounting information and its types, qualitative characteristics of accounting information, users of accounting informations, and systems of accounting. Today we will discuss the meaning and definition of accounting and the attributes of accounting. Let us see the meaning of accounting. Accounting is primarily concerned with recording of financial transactions, summarizing them, and communicating in financial information to the users. So there are three sub part of the process accounting. That is, the first thing is we are recording the financial transaction, then summarizing them, and then communicating the same to the users. Now, who are these users? They are the proprietors, that is the owner of the company, creditors, debtors, investors, government agencies, and employees. Children, these terms are new to you, and in the second chapter, we will go in detail with these terms of accountancy. The next concept, that is the definition of accounting, and it is an important part of this chapter, related to this chapter. You have to by heart this definition of accounting. In this, I have given two definitions. You have to study any one of the definitions. So, American Institute of Certified Public Accountants had defined accounting as an art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money, transactions and events which are in part at least of the financial character and interpreting the results thereof. If I am going to in depth of this definition, let us see what this definition have to convey you. Accountancy is a art in which we record the transaction, we classify them and summarize them in such a useful way that it gives some information to the other parties. And when you are recording the transaction, you have to consider only the money transactions, okay, which have some financial character. And by doing this accounting work, you are actually interpreting the results, which is the output of this process. So this is the first definition of accounting given by American Institute of Certified Public Accountant. See children, the definition you have to study as it is. Okay, you can't write it in your own words, so you have to by heart it. The second definition is accounting is a process. See children, the process means there are some series of steps you have to follow. Okay, so preparing a tea, it is also a process, isn't it? You have to follow some steps. So here accounting is also a process of identifying, measuring and communicating. So you have to identify, then measure and then communicate the economic information to permit informed judgment and decisions by the users of information. It's the same definition with different wordings given by American Accounting Association. Here they are telling that accounting is a process wherein we identify, measure and communicate the economic information or financial information so that the users of it can judge and make decision on the basis of this information. Moving further, let us see the attributes, that means characteristic features of accounting. There are 7 points of characteristics. The first one is identification of financial transaction and events, measuring the identified transaction, recording, classifying, summarizing, analysis and interpretation, and then communicating. So these 7 steps have to be followed when you are going through the process accounting. Let us discuss the 7 points one by one. First one is identification of financial transactions and events. In this, we have to first of all identify whether the transaction entered in a business is of financial nature. See children, accounting records only those transactions and events which are of financial nature. Mother's love to her baby. Can that be a financial transaction? No. So, such events cannot be recorded in the books of accounts. Only those nature transactions which are financial in nature. For example, here you can see purchase of raw materials or sale of finished goods by a company. Here this is a transaction in which give and take is entered, and that too of money value is, see, this transaction is of money value, there something useful have been exchanged between the parties. So purchase and sales of goods in return of something else is a examples of financial nature. So in every transaction, how can you identify that a transaction is of financial nature? That is with the help of bills and receipts. See, whenever you go to a shop to purchase something, in return they will give you a receipt for the purchase you have made and the payment you have given to the other party. Okay, so that transactions which have bills and receipts can be identified as a financial transaction. So first thing is you have to identify whether the transaction is of financial in nature. Then after identifying, you are supposed to measure that identified transaction in some money value. So, that is some units. So, accounting measures the transaction and events in terms of common measurement units. That is money. So, when you purchase a good, say, 1000 bags of cement for ₹2,75,000, and otherwise you have purchased 10 tons of steel for ₹2,50,000, that can be measured in terms of money. Okay, so you are purchasing a goods which for which you have to pay ₹2,75,000. So here some measurable common measurable unit is there when you are going for an accounting transaction. Third one is, once you have identified and then you have measured that transaction in some unit, then now you have to record the same. See, the first entry of any transaction is made in the books of original entry, which is also known as journal. So remember, which is the book of original entry? It's journal. So first time whenever a transaction is entered, we make the entry in the journal book. Okay, and recording is an art of recording the business transaction. Only business transactions will be recorded in the company's book, okay, or books of account. Then other than journal, we also have some other books which is known as subsidiary books. Okay, journal and subsidiary books. So other than journal, we also have subsidiary books. Now after recording the transactions, we will classify them in some common, according to their common nature. So classification is a process of grouping similar transactions at one place. So all the similar transactions will be recorded in one place. Okay. The transactions recorded in the journal or the subsidiary books are classified or posted to the main book of account known as the journal. So once we recorded the transactions in journal, that is the first entry book, then and also in the subsidiary books. Then after doing this, we will classify those transactions according to the by posting the same in the ledger book. So for example, in Rahul's account, in the ledger, all business transactions related to Rahul are posted so that what is ultimately due to Rahul or due from Rahul can be ascertained. So Rahul is our client and to whom we used to purchase the good or sales the good. From whom we used to purchase or we used to sell the goods. So in that case, whatever transaction we have entered with Rahul, that can be seen in a ledger. So that is classifying the transaction at one place. The next is summarizing. This involves presenting the classified data in a manner which is understandable and useful to internal as well as external users of accounting statement. This process leads to preparation of the following statements. So after classifying the books, we are going to summarize it. Okay, for summarizing, we used to prepare trial balance, trading and profit and loss, or which is also known as statement of profit and loss for a company's account, and then balance sheet. So while summarizing, we used to prepare these three books. These three books together is known as final accounts or financial statements. Okay, so why we summarize these things? So that it is understandable and useful. We can make quick decisions on the light of the books prepared, okay, or the statements prepared. So fifth characteristic feature of accounting is summarizing. Then we have analysis and interpretation. So once we have summarized everything, then we can put a conclusion. So whether the business is doing well, performing well, is it positioned in a how is the financial position of the company, that we can make meaningful judgment we can make when the books of account is analyzed or interpreted. So financial data is analyzed and interpreted so that the users of financial data can make a meaningful judgment of financial performance and financial position of the business. So why we are doing such a lengthy process? So that at the end of the day, we can know about the performance and the financial position of the business. Then the last related to the characteristic feature of accounting is communicating. So whatever information you have drafted by going through this process of accounting, that will be communicated to the users. In our first slide, we have seen the users of accounting informations, okay, so like owners, creditors, then banks, bankers or those who give us loan, and then government is there. So many users are there who depend on this informations, so that they can make some decisions are taken at the appropriate time. So decisions of the management depend upon the information gathered from this accounting process. So we have come to an end of today's topic. In today's class, we saw the meaning of accounting, definition of accounting, and characteristic features of accounting. So how was the class, my dear children? I hope you have understood the concept. A YouTube URL is also provided so that you can get to a better understanding about the concept. Children, a test paper is there attached along with this session. So please do attend the test paper and send it by 2 o'clock. And a notes is also there, which you have to write it in your accountancy notebook. So for today, this is all. Meet you in the next class with a new topic.